Thank you. Let's keep it going, church. Yeah, amen. Come on, put your hands together with us. When night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up. You won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on. It won't let go. And I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on. It won't let go. No. I feel it breaking out like an echo. An echo in my soul. Season, you keep repeating the promises to me. Whoa, now there's no stopping what you have started until it is complete. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up. You won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on. It won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on. It won't let go. No. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Echo in my soul. Holding on, it won't let go. And I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on, it won't let go. No, I feel it breaking out, breaking out. Your love is holding on, it won't let go. And I feel it breaking out like an echo. Your love is holding on, it won't let go. No, I feel it breaking out like an echo in my soul. Oh, soul, in my soul, soul. Come on, church, can you give him praise in this place tonight?
Hallelujah. God is good, amen. So good to be in the house of the Lord with you all tonight. You know, I'm excited every time we come in the house of God because God is in this place, and you just never know what might happen. You have a need, but God is here. The way maker is here. The miracle worker is here, amen. So I'm excited for tonight. I'm excited for what God is going to do, and I just want to pray for you right now. So, Father, I just thank you. I thank you for this night. I thank you just that you've given us another day, Lord, that we can worship you, that we can call upon your name, Lord, that we can just give thanks to you for everything that you've given us, God, our lives, our homes, the shelter that you've given us, the food that you've given us, our families, Lord. You are so good. You are so good. And tonight, Lord, we look to you. We look to you for every need that we have, and I thank you that you are the God that sees, and you see each and every one of us. I thank you that you've not forgotten one, but you watch over us, just as your word says. And Lord, when we give our lives to you, you direct every step that we take. So Father, we thank you for that. I thank you for meeting every need, Lord. Those that aren't feeling well, I thank you for your healing power. Those that feel fear or confusion or depression, anything that is not of you, we bind that right now, and we just release your love, your joy, your peace, your strength, your comfort. Those that are mourning tonight, God, comfort them. Father, just continue to be that help that we need in our lives, Lord. And we just give you all of the praise, Lord, all of the honor and all of the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Well, we're going to continue to worship God. Our prayer team is going to be at the front. So if you have any prayer needs tonight, make your way to this altar. Let's agree together. Let's get the help that we need. The Bible says that we simply need to ask. I love the word that says, be anxious for nothing, but by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, make your request known unto God. And then it says, the peace of God that passes understanding. It doesn't make sense. The peace of God will guard your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus. So rather than sitting there being anxious or worried or fretting about your situation, let's make our request known tonight. Amen? Amen. Praise God.
I will love you, Lord, my strength. So hallelujah, our God reigns. Oh, hallelujah, our God reigns. Yes, hallelujah, our God, you reign forever all my days. Hallelujah.
Tries to magnify your situation and bring it out into the light. But how many know that God is greater and he's reigned over that situation? He has victory over that situation. You may feel defeated. You may feel like nothing's coming out of it the way you want it. But how about we give God a try? How about we say, Lord, I don't know how this is going to play out. I don't know how you have this to come to pass, but I see destruction in front of me. I see it to my waist height, Lord, but I'm not going to look over here to the left nor to the right. I'm going to look straight to you, Father, because you, Father, are victorious in my life over my situation, Lord. You have already went before, and you have won the battle, and I have to stand firm on your word. How many want to take a challenge 2020? And as the enemy's voice is speaking, you make God's voice louder. You tune into his voice. And you follow his direction, because I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired of the devil messing with me, with my family, with my household. No more. I stand victorious because he's promised me. He has promised me some things. And I have to tell the devil, you messed up because you brought me back to a place where I'm remembering, and he's speaking things. Don't you remember I told you this? It's okay what you're dealing with, because I'm building something within you. This situation is not made to break you. It's made to make you. And if you allow him to, through the process, through the crushing, our God is faithful. He's so faithful. So stand firm. You may be wavering side to side as the trees blow in the wind, but I promise you, you're not going to break, because no devil in hell has that much power. Our God has that power. Amen. So hallelujah, our God reigns. Yes, hallelujah, our God reigns. Yes, hallelujah, our God, you reign forever, all my days. Hallelujah. So hallelujah, our God reigns. Yes, hallelujah, our God reigns. Yes, hallelujah, our God, you reign forever, all my days. Hallelujah.
Jesus, you reign. Jesus, you reign.
Lord, we offer up a praise to you, Jesus. You're so worthy, Lord. You're so good. What a beautiful name, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You were.
Nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name.
Can we just worship him?
Have no rival. You have, come on.
You have no rival. You have no equal. Now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the glory. Yours is
come on. Worship him in this place. Powerful name. You know, sorry, Pastor Felix, but people approach me and they say, can you pray for me? Can you pray for this person? Can you pray for that? Can you pray for this? Can you pray for that? And when I think of that song, sometimes we walk in doubt, you know, because it looks like the need is so great. Like, there's no way that someone can be healed from a stroke or that they can speak again. And I want you to know, I'm believing for a family member who had a stroke probably about 5 or 6 years ago, and I want his speech to be fully restored. And I don't know about you, if that takes a certain type of faith or if that takes a certain type of belief, but when we say, what a powerful name, we don't have to walk in defeat. We don't have to walk like the enemy is greater than that. So we need to make our worship personable to God. We need to make it so personal that it doesn't matter who's surrounding us. It doesn't matter. We come to get what God has for us. Amen? Amen. And then you're amongst a whole bunch of believers that will stand with you and lift you up and encourage you. Amen? In this place. Amen. How many of you want to see a miracle in this place? Like, just change someone's life in this place. So can we sing that bridge? But let's sing that bridge with all authority and take dominion and take back all of the things that the enemy was trying to hold from you. Amen. Death could not hold you. The veil tore before you. The silence, the boast. Come on. The heavens are for you. The heavens are. Come on. The praise of his glory. See, what you thought was dead, he rose to life again. Jesus has no equal.
You have no rival.
There is no one that can defeat him.
Elevate Life Church. Can we spend the next 15 seconds giving them all the praise, giving them all the glory? No matter if you had a crazy work week, no matter if you barely got here on time, let's give them all the praise. Come on, 5 more seconds. If we could just give them the glory in this place, because he is worthy to be praised. Thank you, Lord. We worship you. We magnify your name. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Well, I'm so glad you guys are here tonight. I know that your life is never going to be the same, and I don't say that out of cliche or just out of routine. I really believe that your life is going to be impacted, that whatever you were believing God for, that you've been praying and believing God for, whatever it is, it will come to pass. Don't give up. Don't give up now. Don't quit now. Listen, God has a word for you today. God has a word for you today that's going to turn that situation around. Do you guys receive that in the house this evening? Amen. Well, let's do this. If we can just come out of our seats this evening and just go around, walk around, greet someone, tell them, good evening, it's good to see you. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you made it. Amen. Oh, okay. All right. Good evening. Good evening. How many of you guys met someone new tonight? You went to introduce yourself to someone new tonight. Who is it? Thank you, Rocky. I appreciate that. Yes, Rocky. Just He didn't want me just to be alone in that. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Well, welcome everyone to Elevate Life Church. On behalf of our pastors, Pastor Tom and Heather, I am Pastor Felix, one of the associate pastors here, and I want to welcome you here tonight. If this is your first time here, let's do this. Can we welcome all of our first-time attendees here at Elevate Life Church?
Amen.
I know Pastor Heather has already welcomed you guys, but what I would love for you guys to do is we would love to know who was with us here tonight at Elevate Life Church, especially if this is your first time here. On the front of your seat, that's what we call our connection card. If you can just take a few moments out during the time of our service and just fill that out, you can drop it in the offering bucket as it comes around, or you can drop it over in one of our drop boxes, or you can, there's ushers here that will be more than willing to take that as well. But once again, we just want to know who was here. Maybe you have a prayer request. We want to believe in God with you and standing with you that whatever it is that you're believing God for, it shall come to pass. We want to welcome all of our online viewers, though, too, as well. Can we welcome all of our online viewers tonight? Amen.